Think big. It's something that we hear about pretty often, but not something that we often practice.
It's a mantra that, you know, can help us take on bigger challenges and make bigger goals for ourselves. Speaking of bigger goals, Margie Warrell is here. You just came back from L.A., and I'm going to talk about you for a second because we usually are coming to you for tips, but I think this is so cool. Everybody's heard about Oprah Winfrey. She's retiring from her talk show, and all these hopefuls have gone to L.A. What, 20,000 of them?
Well, no, they've gone around the country, and there have been people who've turned up for these auditions, and then people can also audition online.
Well, this is the audition to be the next big talk show
they're
star.
Going to
yes.
do,
Oprah has
yeah,
a
and they're going to do a reality show. I think it's going to be a bit like American Idol, where they get 10 contestants who compete against each other for the best talk show.
So you went to LA to be the next Oprah, basically.
To throw my hat into the ring.
Right, to be the next Oprah. Tell us what happened when you got there.
Well, you know, it was a fascinating experience. They said, you know, from 8 o'clock you needed to be there. Well, I got there really early. I was on East Coast time.
You were on Australia time.
I was certainly on East Coast time. And I got there at 5:30 in the morning, and there was like 1,000 people there already. So there was like a cattle call for Oprah wannabes.
So it was like American Idol tryouts.
It was a bit like that. And you know, I was talking to different people, and I'm not sure if they'll show the footage or not, but you know, there was people, someone from Nigeria, someone from Hong Kong.
Wow.
I met several other people from the East Coast, which seemed crazy. And they actually did these auditions in New York and Atlanta, but I just couldn't make those ones.
So tell us, it's got to be like American Idol. You probably look at people and go, why is that person here?
Well, you know, there were some people there. Like, there was a guy. Did you ever watch Days of Our Lives?
Yeah, I mean,
there was a guy called John Black who used to be like Marlene. Like, he was a key. Like, he was on Oprah 20 years ago as the big... the hottest hunk in daytime soap. He was there trying out. He was
really?
In the same
Goodness.
Group as me. So I thought, you know, they've got all sorts of people showing up.
Well, maybe he wants to be the next Kelly Ripa. You know, she came out of the soaps, right?
There
yeah.
you go.
Yeah.
So
true.
What happens? You go into a room? Are there judges in front of you?
Yeah. No, actually, they had 12 people at a time doing it. You had like a minute or two to pitch yourself, who you are, what kind of show you'd want to create, and why you would be good at, be a great TV show host.
Do they time you?
They sort of, you know, they told you. They didn't say... stop, but they, you know, you knew that you needed to just wind it up if you went too long. I didn't, but there were some people when I was sitting there listening to some people, I'm thinking, wind it up.
Oh, you can
well,
listen to
others. I just really want to help people, and I just always want to be on TV. And
I really want to be rich like Oprah.
She's just everything, and you know. So there was a girl crying. I really want to be Oprah.
Oh,
this
please,
is my dream.
Getting down on her hands
How
and knees.
Sad.
There were some really elderly people there who said, "This is my dream." So you know, there was
my dream before I die.
I know. And I said, "How long have you had that dream?" They're like, "Oh, 35 years." And what have you done toward that? And they're like, "Well, I've watched a lot of Oprah." You
know? Well, they're
learning
honest.
From the pro, right.
But you know, the reason I went, the odds are so long for anything like this, but I would love to have a TV show. I would love to share my message of living more boldly with more people. And this obviously this is an opportunity to kind of share what it is you're passionate about with millions of people. And while the odds are long, you know, as Wayne Gretzky said, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. And, you know, I think life's about, you know, sticking your neck out and making yourself vulnerable every now and again and, you know, putting yourself at risk of failing, looking foolish, or just being disappointed.
That's
and
good.
If you
know,
don't go for it, you don't have a chance for them even to say yes or no.
Yeah.
You.
Mm-hmm. And
you're
you
not
know
even
what?
In the running.
I knew that if I didn't do it, I would sit there thinking, what if I tried? And I didn't want to have to go, well, what if I tried? So now
yeah,
I know if
factor.
Nothing comes of it, at least I know, hey, I tried.
This is a great lesson for all of us, isn't it? Setting that
totally.
Bar high.
What did you say to them? I've got to know. What was your minute stick?
Well, I said that this is, well, who I am. I'm a life coach, and I said, and an author, and I said, I would love to create a program that really challenged people to thinking bigger and giving them the strategies and the inspiration they need to do that and to deal better in their relationships, in their work, in their relationship with food and health and well-being, and to help people who are struggling with adversity trust in themselves and get through it better.
I think you'd make a great host. What do you think, Natasha?
Yeah, so now you just wait.
Well, if you guys want to, I'll take over your jobs if you want to, like, that'll be a start.
I was looking for a day off this week, so.
But, you know, there were lots of people. Some people had ideas on, like, one guy, he wanted to come up with a reality show about America's best script. Another person I met, she was all about nursing mothers, and she wanted to create a show about nursing. And then I said to her, that's great. You know, do you nurse? She goes, oh, I have a two-year-old. I'm still nursing. And I thought,
a two-year-old?
I thought, well, I think you're probably a little bit too out there, but who knows? There was lots of interesting people with interesting ideas.
So are you going to be, is it kind of like American Idol where they'll make a show out of the outtakes of everybody? They should.
I think they will. I think actually I thought I heard this week, Friday on Oprah, they might be doing something about the audition process. So
maybe we'll see you.
You might see me saying hi. They did actually get me to go on camera afterwards and just say what my experience was. So who knows whether that will be used in their many hours of footage or not. But
wow,
it was a fun experience. I met some interesting people.
And we're going to say we knew her when.
Exactly.
She was, you just know, alive.
Missy, you got your start here in our living room.
Don't hold your breath. But all I can say is, you know, it was a great thing to do. And whatever comes of it, I'm really glad I did it. Because, you know, you're kind of living full out when you do stuff like that. So that was
good. Let's talk a little bit about goals.
Yeah.
About, you know, since you're our life coach here, to
yes,
tell us how we can achieve our goals. First of all, setting that bar up high, not setting it too low.
Yeah, well, you know, I think we fail more from timidity than we do from over-daring. So what is it that you really want? So many people don't get clear about what they really want, whether it's in their relationships or their jobs or their lives in general. I think you need to create a vision, because any area of your life where you don't have a clear vision, you're not as powerful as you could be. You know, you really kind of tap in inner resources when you're clear about this is what I want. And I think then just being prepared to take those courageous steps. And, you know, I wrote a book on courage, because courage isn't the absence of fear or self-doubt. Courage is action in the presence of it. So, like for me, jumping on a plane, leaving my husband with 4 kids for the weekend.
That was courage.
You know, and for
that
other people,
courage.
It's picking up the phone and asking someone out on a date, or it's, you know, applying for a job. It's going, speaking up to their boss about what they'd like to do. It's putting yourself out there and taking a risk.
On that note, we got to go. Margie, thanks for coming
it's
in.
Great
and good
to
luck
be here. Thank you. I'll let you know.
I hope they use a clip of you.
Oh, I do too. Who knows?
It'll be good.
I think you'd be great. Yeah.
Gotta watch Friday. Coming up, we're getting a look.